Hello, this is Daniel Torres here, live from Shoptalk Europe in London, joined by a very special guest who I've known for a few years. This is Iradj Boroumand, joining us from SC Johnson. How are you?
I'm good, Daniel. Happy to be here and good to, I guess, meet in person for the first time as well, which is a bit of a change from having phone calls and video calls. Shall I maybe introduce myself to the audience?
Absolutely.
So the name's Iradj. I head up the European e-commerce business at SC Johnson. Been in e-commerce for 7 to 8 years now, and been in CPG and fast-moving consumer goods for the last 13. So pretty much my career started out at Kimberly Clark, then went to Lavazza, and now 2.5 years at SC Johnson. So yeah, it's been a good journey in CPG so far.
Yeah, and you're based out in, what is it, Geneva?
Lausanne. So Lausanne. On Lake Geneva. But yeah, it's I get the pleasure of having the Swiss Alps and Lake Geneva as my backdrop from my balcony. Not complaining.
Are you trying to compete with Barcelona?
It's a tough one. I think you'd give me a run for my money, that's for sure.
Fair enough. And so you've been for 2 years. How long did you say?
Just over 2 years.
Okay. And what 2 years, no? I mean, what did you join, just before COVID started?
Literally January 2020. So I spent 3-4 weeks in the office, and then it was 2 years, pretty much 2 years mostly at home. So interesting time to join a new company where you're working with global, regional and local teams. And doing everything remote is definitely an additional challenge, sure. But it was good. I mean, at the same time, because of the pandemic and the lockdown, there was all of a sudden a heightened sense of urgency to get things done on e-commerce and to, as our chairman would say, be where the consumer is going. And very much in that case, the consumer was shopping online and still is shopping online. It was actually a perfect time. It was the perfect storm to join because there was good momentum. It is a growing part of the business, like it is in many businesses. And some of our products lend themselves well to be bought online. Some of our products, which are more like problem solve categories. Yeah. One has a blocked drain. Okay, how do I unblock my drain without having to call a plumber, or I'll use a Mr. Muscle product? And so that's where your online journey starts. So It's been a very rich 2 years in fixing a lot of what I consider the brilliant basics, which, frankly speaking, we overlook. Things like making sure our digital shelves are how they should be, getting the right supply chain governance and processes, data capabilities in place, building people's digital IQ, raising that within the company. Honestly, it's been a good couple of years for sure.
Yeah, no, it's interesting that you talk about the digital shelf, because I was telling you that I just had a chat with Syndigo, which some of our listeners will have heard, because I just uploaded it now as well.
Ah, great.
And they were talking about like the digital shelf, how much they've noticed that people like you have noticed like a bigger awareness of like that it's good to be consistent on the digital shelf, to have all your data on there and so on.
You know, Daniel, e-commerce is very straightforward, and I don't even like calling it e-commerce. You know, it's just, I would say, interacting, driving experiences with consumers online is probably a better way of talking about it. It's very simple. You focus on your discoverability. Can consumers find my products in the first place? And then to your point, when they find them, is it relevant? And does it give them everything they need to convert, or to at least drive the right level of purchase consideration? And then as long as you make sure your product's available, you have the right price elasticity, your brand and product assortment is in place, then the rest goes by itself. So really not rocket science, but yeah, I can see why the Syndigo guys would be for seeing that as well, because, you know, whether we like it or not, for some shopping missions, people need more than 5 seconds to make a decision. Now, sometimes they'll do that in 2 seconds because they're in their routinized purchase mode, and you have bought that candle before, so I'll buy it again. But if you're buying a new insect repellent or something that impacts your skin, trust me, you will need the right content to make that decision. So, and the same goes with user-generated content. I personally, as a consumer myself, love reading ratings and reviews, the reviews before and seeing the average rating before I buy a product.
Yeah.
Whether that's booking a hotel, whether that's buying a physical, actual new product, or I want to know what why someone gave that a one or a five star.
Yeah. Do you think this data part is like the name of the game now, in terms of like e-commerce? Like now that we've seen e-commerce really explode during COVID, maybe now going a bit lower. Maybe I'm wrong, actually. Yeah, you tell me. Like having the right data, fighting to be on the first page, is that like really the opportunity, or just one of many?
It's one of many, and look, it's not even being on the first page. You know, it's being on the first row of the first page. Yeah. Let's be honest, because if you'd see click-through rates on row 2, 3, 4 down, you see the percentages drop quite dramatically. So it's not even winning inorganic ranking on page one. It's winning on placement one or placement two even. So of course, we're all fighting to drive our organic ranking, especially on marketplaces like Amazon, where it's done algorithmically, and you have also some paid opportunities there. So we're all trying to bid for the same media to get our products in front of consumers. So of course, in a more crowded space, who gets seen is of course what matters. So it's one piece of a bigger puzzle. Now, in terms of the first point you mentioned on, in a, I guess, a category or in a space that's slightly not, well, not growing as quick anymore. Look, it's definitely still growing. It grew in the last 2 years at a rate that probably expected to be the CAGR for the next 5 years. So we are annualizing or pumping huge growth rates from the past year. So yeah, we're seeing some contraction happening, but it's not just online. Actually, if you look at in-store spending, with the inflationary environment we're in, people are making some tough choices and spending is being hit by that. So I think it's a bit of a combination of, yes, we've come out of a pandemic, so okay, we see some shoppers doing some of their weekly shopping trips back in store, and because you know, a shopper doesn't just do online shopping, or they shop across based a variety of platforms based on the mission, you know, so the shopping trip, so some of that is going back into the store, which is normal because some people just like to touch their fruits and vegetables and what have you. And then with the inflation environment, is definitely adding a layer on top. So people are focused on paying their electricity bills and their gas bills. And so I don't think it's particular on e-com, if that makes sense. It's just, it's the macro environment we find ourselves in.
Yeah. And how have you found being on, I mean, is it your first business trip? Probably not, no, since things have started opening up.
No, actually we've been, you know, we're, we pride ourselves on being a company that really cares for its people and having the people close to one another,
a family company
at the end of the day. So having that close interaction with each other is important. So we do try to, where possible, you know, meet in person. So actually I had the fortunate position to organize an e-commerce summit last month here in London, where we were for a couple of days in the Amazon office in Shoreditch as well. Oh, wow. So it was great to get all the teams who, frankly speaking, hadn't seen each other because they were operating in their local markets. And of course, they all knew each other by name. But so it's great. I think in e-commerce, there's a lot of talent coming from various different functions, whether it's marketing, sales, supply chain, you name it. And just seeing that talent in one room is always very inspirational and a sign of the journey we've been on at SCJ here in Europe. So.
Yeah.